Hello and welcome to the InDesign Troubleshooting tutorial. Today we're going to talk about stability issues with InDesign and how to fix those problems. Let's take a look at our problem. I have here a document that consists of 39 pages and they are all threaded together, the text frames here. If I now try to write in here, you will see that it is lagging quite a bit. I'm pressing the key constantly. With InDesign lagging so bad, it's really difficult to type something, so we're going to cover several approaches to solve this problem. In case you already know some of those, I'm going to run over the things we're going to learn today, so you can skip them if you want. You can click on the buttons over there to go to the topic you want to see first. We will start pretty basic by talking about how to get rid of document history and also how to display your pictures in a lower resolution. Then we're going to cover how to get whole picture arrangements or pictures that contain a lot of vector files into Illustrator to save them again and import them back into InDesign as an Illustrator file so we don't have vectorized data lying around directly in InDesign. In the last step, we're going to talk about how to take threaded text frames, if you have 30 or more text frames threaded together, how to divide those, and with Smart Text Reflow, how to get InDesign to work a little bit more reliable. So if you want to skip to one of those topics, just click over there on the topic. We can get started with the first one. You can download the sample document we're going to use today on our website, and you find the link in the YouTube description. We can open our document and you see it has 9 pages and also a picture in here. And this actually isn't very slow, but it's just an example that shows you how to fix it on your long document. The first thing is really easy. You can go to File and Save As, and you're just going to save your document again. Let's call this one New. And if we now take a look at the document size, we see this is 2.5 megabytes big. You see the new document is much smaller because InDesign did get rid of a lot of history like edits and so on that is not really need for a document itself. So this might already speed up InDesign a little bit. We're going to keep working in the new document. And the other thing is with pictures, you might want to go on View and change the display performance. If you have it on high quality display, it might use a lot of power from your computer. So typical display is normally fine. If you put it on fast display, you don't see a picture at all like this. So normally to keep it on typical display is all right. Next, if you take a look at a picture like this, you see it has a lot of vector graphics in here. And you should try to avoid using a lot of vector graphics directly inside InDesign, because InDesign needs to save all this information directly in the document. This could also be a picture arrangement with a lot of annotations, and then you would end up with a lot of vector graphics as well, or a lot of pictures that are complicated arranged, and so on. So the best thing is to put those graphics, if we select the whole thing, into another program. So we're going to copy this with Command C, and we're going to insert it into Illustrator. Let's create a new file in Illustrator. We want to create this one for print, and it should be A4 size. You can click on OK. And we're just going to paste in our copied picture. Now we need to reduce the size of the artboard. And it snaps to your picture if you have Command U, the smart guy is activated. So you can press Command U to deactivate or activate this. And this fits perfectly to the size of the frame now. So this is fine. One thing, if you want to edit your pictures, inside InDesign it was the way I could do changes directly in this picture and then update this in the InDesign document. The same would work for Illustrator as well. But at the moment, this picture is not linked. We can now take a look at the Links panel. You find it in Windows under Links. And you see now we have here our picture. We can select it in here. and this symbol indicates that it's embedded in the document itself. However, if we relink this, we can select the froggy picture and click on place, and we see now this symbol here is gone and our picture is linked. You can also double click to view the information of your picture, and you see here the location of the picture as well. If we now do edit in this picture, let's open it in Photoshop. Let's just remove something from here, like this. We save this one. And now in Illustrator, we see it tells us the picture was modified of this frog and asks us if we want to update it. We can click on No. And we also can then update the picture in here manually by clicking this symbol. Update link, and now we see our change in the picture. Let's next import this Illustrator picture into InDesign. We can get rid of our old graphic. And then we're going to place the Illustrator file. And just click, and there we have our new picture. You now see it's a little bit pixelated. This is because of our view in the display performance. And now this will take a lot less power of your computer to display. If the previous tricks didn't work for you and you still have stability problems with InDesign, especially while typing, this might help you. In our document, we're using Smart Text Reflow. This means if you have text in one document and it would have an overlap over here, it will flow directly to the other document. So imagine all these pages here would be full of text. And this, if you type, for example, something in here, is a problem because InDesign needs to check for all the other pages how the typing over here affects the distribution of the text, for example, on the last page. So if you have like 80 pages, this needs a lot of calculation power and makes InDesign a little bit slow. One solution for this problem is actually to divide your text frames. So if we would do a cut in here, we could still change something in here, but InDesign would have less pages where it needs to calculate the changes. So to accomplish this, to divide your text frames, so to say, you need to select the text that you want to put into new frames. So let's say we're copying the text from page 5 to page 8, like this. So you select the whole text by placing the cursor in here, pressing the shift key and clicking over here, so the whole text is selected. And then you need to move this text onto a new page. And on this new page here, there's a standard size text frame. And you're going to move the text from here into this text frame. Then you will get a plus sign because you have overflow text. The text from four sides can't fit on one. And you need then to create a new text frame that will be linked to the first one. And once you have this, you need to make sure that you have Smart Text Reflow activated in your InDesign options. And if it's activated, it will insert two more pages that are also linked under each other, like this. And you will end up with something over here. You see here, you have actually two separate text bodies, so to say, where the Smart Text Reflow only works for one at a time. So if you do changes in here, for example, it only needs to calculate the changes to this point. And if it needs to insert a page, it will insert a page after page 4 and just move the source page further down in the document. So this really helps to make InDesign more stable. So let's take a look how this looks in a real life example. We are back in our InDesign document. And the first thing I want to do is to insert two pages at the end of the document. We have selected after page 9, which is our last page. We click OK, and here we have our two pages inserted. We're going to copy this text box and paste it on here. Of course, we should align it, and we can delete the text inside of this. And then we're going to copy this box again and also align it in here. Now we can decide where we want to divide our document. And if you have a picture that you want to use, it's always a good idea to divide your documents on pictures that would fill a whole page like this, because in this case, you would start with a new page anyway. So we say we divide it here. Normally you would insert a break character and a page break, and then insert your picture here and put a page break again. However, in this case, we're going to select the whole text we have left, go to page 9, press the shift key and click, and now we have the whole text selected from page 6 to page 9. And we can move this now to page 10. Just drag and drop. And here we have our text. Now we have this little overset symbol here. And we're going to select this and link it to the next page. This will now automatically, with Smart Text Reflow, insert the pages it needs to fill everything out. Actually, we didn't need this one, so we can get rid of this page again. Click on OK. And then we could also copy this picture and place it in here. Let's get the alignment right. And of course, you would add a headline for your picture and choose the figure numbering. Something like this. If we now take a look at our text frames, we should check in View, Extras, Show Text Threads. We see from here to here it's still threaded, but then from here to the next page there is no thread. And from here the thread starts again. So if I type in here, this is page 7, it would add pages if needed. And also if I type something on page 3, for example, it would insert pages after page 6. So this should increase the speed of InDesign and the stability. Alright, if the tip with the Smart Text Reflow didn't do the trick for you, there is one last chance, and this is to organize your document in a book structure. And actually, there is a whole tutorial on this, and you can click here to watch it. Alright, this was our tutorial for today. I strongly recommend using the book function, because you, in this beginning, you never know how long your document might be. So make sure to also watch this video over here. So see you next time. Bye bye.